This video is a crash course of the Prism pipeline for animation and VFX projects. In the next few minutes, I will show you the basic features and how you can use them. So let's start. When you have installed Prism, you can type Prism Tray in the Windows search to open the tray icon. Click on the icon to create your first project. When you have created your first project, you can click on the tray icon to open the project browser. Here you can double-click in the asset hierarchy to create new assets. Double-click in the steps list to create new pipeline steps, and from the right-click menu you can create new scene files. Click on the scene files to open them. In the Shots tab you can create new shots by double-clicking in the first list. You can set a sequence name and a shot name. Then you can create pipeline steps and scene files like in the Assets tab. In your 3D application, you can save your scene file to a new version by clicking on the Save Version icon in the Prism shelf. To export objects, open the State Manager and create an export state. Set a task name and output file format, and then you can publish your scene file to export your objects. When you publish your scene, all states in the export list will be executed. To import objects, open the State Manager and create a new import state. In the Select Task dialog, you can select an asset or a shot, a task, and double-click on a version to import it. If you import a scene file, you can create a reference from it. You can also create playblast and render states in the State Manager. Define the settings on the right side and publish your scene to execute all states in the State Manager export list. Prism handles the output path automatically. To review your playblast and renderings, select a shot or an asset, select a task and a version, and double-click on the preview image. This will open the files in the media player. From the right-click menu, you can convert your image sequences to a video file. This completes the crash course of the Prism pipeline. For a step-by-step introduction, go to prism-pipeline.com/tutorials. You can also support the development of Prism with a little donation on the website. I hope Prism can help you to improve your workflow and to create better projects. Thanks for watching.